Thanks for watching Moses Cen-Valley. Like, share, subscribe.
It just came in the mail. The little side project. I got the keyways too, but I'm not sure this is the right way, but I'm just going to put it in there so it don't get lost. Basically, this washer fits here perfectly. It goes in there. The point is, you know, to fit everything in there, but that's pretty cool. I'm like, not saying I'm closer, but one step closer. Grooves are going to effect mess up the performance. No, no. I think the guy should have designed it more smooth instead of all these rigid edges. That just gives him less hours on his machine so he could produce more. But anyway, yeah. Not too sure which wire goes to where. But I'm pretty sure it just gives me a second or two. Just gave the dog some water. Check him out. What's up, Bubbas? A little burp. He's a fatty.
Taking the engine out to install a Piaggio race engine.
I'll do a quick update on my bike rundown. I just got the exhaust stage 6. Pretty centered straight. I use a chain tensioner and a big spacer. So all that is on there. The pedals miss, so it doesn't rub, doesn't hit. Has a little clearance on the frame itself. Custom header. That's it, YouTube. I blew up the bike. The motor's right here. Not fully assembled, but pretty much, I mean, blew up, as in I blew everything apart. Took everything apart. The bike is stripped down to its shiny little frame. Let's see what I come up with. I'll probably do the final, do like a montage of what happens to the bike.
I want to say I spent a few hours in repolishing the frame, because the next step, what I'm going to do to the frame, requires to be polished unless I want a satin finish, and that's was not what I was going for. I want reflection on my frame, so you can see the frame, it looks pretty good. Took a few hours of my time, but I think it came out great.
I just got a generic aftermarket style Macoon carb, Macoonie style carb, I guess it's called. This is a 21 millimeter. I'm gonna run 21 millimeter on the Piaggio. I liked it because it has that red anodized glow to it. Polished black anodize. Check that out. Deadpool version 2. I don't know if this is the Deadpool when he gets attacked by Venom and he becomes Venom Deadpool. But look at that. Pretty cool.
The frame is not the only thing I anodized. You can see I anodized the head, intake, all the covers. Check it out.
So basically, this is the carburetor, 21 millimeter. I'm gonna run 21. I think honestly, you could run 19 millimeter on this type of engine, but I'm running a 21, so it's a little bit bigger. So I might not even have to change the jets. All I have to do is tune the air and gas flow, and maybe the needle, and I'll probably have a good running engine. You can see I got the motor mounts in red. Then I got the chain tensioner and the exhaust bracket. Basically, this is the exhaust bracket. It goes right here, if you've seen this little spacer shim.
Then I even got the flower nut for the clutch, red. But not too sure if I'm gonna use it, but it's red. It looks cool. It's the RDM slim looking clutch cable, bucking bar thing. Then I got the V-Force red intake, red spacer. I'm going Deadpool. Basically, it's all Deadpool. Frame, anodized black. So it's all good. It's gonna be a pretty cool bike when it's all done. Definitely Deadpool. And then I have a custom decal that is gonna go right here. Knickknacks that I gotta go figure out the spacing of my engine. That's okay, but I really do want to get the rim set before I start putting more stuff to it, because I'm just gonna drop it and scratch and nick the things. So I do have a personal, I just have a blanket for it. I'm gonna wrap it up, store it, and won't scratch nothing. And by the time I get my rim set, I could start putting this thing together. Brand new spark plug, brand new carburetor. The whole bike's brand new this, that. I put black anodized, but brush finished, and then stage 6 silencer. And this is the exhaust I'm running. There's the engine. Looking for my front end. I enjoy the video. As you can see, I cut the head tube.
It's more for a setup on the video. I'm going to explain how I have it spaced out, how it's a good thing to check fit it and take time when building a complete build.
Definitely when you're going all out and you're making it nice to your liking. Definitely if it's repainted or something. This is anodized. This should let you know this ain't not paint. But yeah, I'll show you the setup.
Okay, first, basically, put on the forks. Then install your headset shim like that. Then install the headset dust cover. Now I'm running one of these Speedline spacers, ceramic and red. Then you install the top of the triple tree. And I'm gonna use one carbon fiber spacer. Now all I gotta do is put the stem in bars. Check that out. Now if you look inside here, there's like half a millimeter of depth there, but it still has to be compressed. So I'm gonna put the spacer here. It actually sinks in down to the stem. Then install the top cap. So this is how my whole setup on the front end.
I also got the new rim set, but I wasn't happy with them, so I did this. Much better. That red anodized spacers, red anodized valve cap, I think it looks pretty good, and it got some nice rubber. You can see how flush this sits. Basically, you just gotta shave this to erase that raised edge. Actually, first prototype of the Merc clutch. Second version is gonna be a lot slimmer. Hey Ethan, question, how do you take this off? What's up? This is gonna be a quick install video of the prototype Merc clutch. Probably not the best video, but
check it out. Basically what I did so far was I installed the bearing on the actual clutch plate, and then I put the shaft, and I put the clutch on the end of the shaft. What you're gonna have to do is put the key in there. I'm gonna put the key just to make it easy for us to watch the video. Then you're gonna install the actual Merc clutch, slide that in there, and then you're gonna put your sealed bearing bevel gear. And like I said in my other video, it's nice and flush. And it doesn't scrape, and it's smooth, and it's not gonna, you're not gonna have to play on this bevel gear. Now, you're gonna install it. Oh, give me a second, I wanna zoom into that. Okay, can you see that? All right, so you gotta make sure your gear's on there. Slide your gear, try to slide your thing, make sure it's hooked on, and boom. It's on there, and there's very little bit of play, and that's because of the sealed bearing. This thing's not gonna go nowhere. You can see, it's on there, it's even, so when it spins, nothing happens. We're gonna show the, give me a sec. The other side is just as easy, believe it or not. I thought that was kind of easy. We're gonna let this side. You put your sprocket. I'm going with the 11 tooth. So I'm gonna put your sprocket in here. Then you're gonna put your lock collar. You see, it has this freaking locking down. I gotta break it loose, so give me a sec. Basically, I don't have Allen wrench with me here. I'm using my finger. Give me a second. Basically, you can see if I didn't have this video recording me, this thing could have been installed already with the bevel, with the locking pin, by locking, with the shafts, the keys, the locking keys in there. You break that loose, slide this in there. You got that little bit of gap. It's all good. I specifically got this washer here, this size washer, because it fits perfectly, like, over it. Look at that. Like, it covers it perfectly. So we're going to put this in here.
Deadpool clutch is connected. The 3D Motorsport clutch is connected thanks to the Merc clutch adapter. And you can see once I press the clutch in, moving the cable, moves the pads. I'm gonna move the bike. I'm doing it with one hand, guys. So I'll move the bike. Yeah, it's gripped. So now we'll press it. It spins the tire flawlessly, Mortal Kombat style. So we're ready to actually put gas in this bike. First day out on the Deadpool Piaggio bike build. Man, this power band kicks in pretty good. I don't know how the other guys out in the races. There he comes.